Here's how I would suggest that you handle disagreements around best practice. Do the thing that the other person wants to do first. That's always a good way, right? Feels inclusive. It's gonna feel terrible to you because you're gonna feel like you know the right thing. It's gonna feel awesome to them because they're gonna feel like there's some trust and willingness. That's one way to go about it. Maybe an easier way to think about this is that there's no such thing as best practice. There are good practices that are context bound. As a matter of fact, the things that you are gonna see that cause pain inside of an organization or that that make the interactions between the development staff and the operations staff difficult, those are actually the result of earlier best practices. So a thing that we need to be very, very clear about is that there's only good practices, and those good practices have a lifespan. And so when you walk in, the first thing you want to do is you want to develop that sense of appreciative inquiry. It's not, oh man, how did it get like this? It's, oh, I wonder how it got this way. What was the value that that drove the organization? What value were they chasing? What things did they see as being amazing that brought them to this place? And how do we recapture the things that we think are valuable? It's very, very easy to declare the thing bad and then to want to describe some new good state. And this is often how best practices work. I cannot tell you how many times I've shown up on a site to talk with some executives or with a team, and the first thing they want to know is, Jeff, give me the checklist of all the best practices. And in fact, I can't do that, even if I wanted to. And often I do want to, because it feels like they would be super happy if I could give it to them. I know that it's a little bit of a fib. That in fact, what's going to have to happen is the organization is going to have to work together to find a set of tooling. That set of tooling is different contextually from place to place. Different vendors take different approaches to the problem domain, and some work better in some contexts and others in others. And I think your job in the role of DevOps engineer is to really help the organization to discover the right set of tooling. What no organization needs right now is another voice in like the war on which tool is best. It's an easy trap for a junior engineer to fall into. I would encourage you at the beginning of your learning process to avoid it. First of all, learn all the tools. There are differences. There are differences in approach and technique that are super valuable. And you never know when you're going to need that sort of super special screwdriver to solve that particular problem. So as a new engineer working in the DevOps space, you're going to come into an organization, and often you're going to come in with a list of like, these are all the best practices, these are the best tools. And you know, it'd be great if you just landed at a place where everyone agreed. But in fact, what probably is going to happen is you're going to land into a place where people are already in sort of violent disagreement. And if what you bring is that is more advocacy, you're never going to get to the place that you want to get, which is the ability to unlock that value. So as a new DevOps engineer in an organization that's sort of can't find its way toward a tool set, I think taking the stance of advocacy for any particular tool is not going to be the place where you're bringing value. The most valuable stance you can take is the one in which you help the organization to kind of co-discover what works in its context.